He was strength and conditioning expert Memo Herdia, one of the best in the business. Memo, how does a knockout work? You were strength and conditioning, you worked with Romano Marquez, you worked with Badu Jackie, Shea Smith, and many other great fighters. What's the, from a neurological aspect, how does it work?
You know, most of the time what a knockout happens is because it's in a defensive mode. Your body goes into a defensive mode and it shuts down and restart the process of the whole engine again. So sometimes when a boxer gets hit in the chin, there's a reaction that occurs in the brain. That reaction triggers a knockout. So sometimes, like I said, some boxers have the ability to overcome that. Some boxers, that reaction triggers real quick, and that's why you ended up losing your legs right away. Some of them get up quick, some of them they don't. Depends on how hard is the punch.
So I get hit on my chin. So what happens from the second that the punch lands? So what happens?
Well, you know, your inside, your membranes move. There's a reaction that has to do with calcium that interferes with neural communication. So from there on, it's different mechanism that occurs just to prevent you or prevent any further injury and brain damage.
So you knock out, and when do you wake up? 5 seconds, a minute, 30 seconds, when they slap you?
Well, you know.
Everybody's different?
Everybody's different. I mean, you've seen it on a boxing. I mean, you got boxers that they get dropped, they get up right away, they don't, you know, like immediately. They don't drop.
Tim Bradley.
Like Bradley, he gets up and he's still boxing. He might be off a little bit, but still boxing. Some boxers just don't get up, like Pacquiao, you know, in the Marcus Fight Pacquiao, he was, I think, a minute.
People were worried. People were actually genuinely worried about him, Memo.
I was worried too. I mean, you know, it's something.
But he's okay, and we're happy about it. But that's a knockout that takes you out.
Definitely.
Is there any specific thing that happens when the chin, because they say that once there's a little hairline, and the more you get knocked out, the more faster you'll get knocked out. Have you ever heard that?
I always think that the knockout, you need to have a strength, real, real strong legs to be able to sustain the ability of a knockout. I mean, sometimes there's athletes who unfortunately don't work the legs, so what happens is you get hit, obviously that reaction triggers, then what happens is the legs just collapse on you. So no, that's different. There's different theories on that, and there's a few studies that, like I said, the chemical reactions that occur in your brain, that's not a theory. That's something that is proven. So other than that, sometimes there's a lot of myths in boxing, and I just can't believe any of it.
My last question. We're here at the Floyd Mayweather gym. He's 48-0. He's fighting Andre Brito. What does Floyd Mayweather mean to boxing?
Well, he's a legend. You know, he's a legend. He's proven. He's gotten the best. He's fought the best. He's fought the best, and he's 48-0. So definitely, if he's leaving tomorrow, he's leaving a legado that a lot of people are gonna follow, and always gonna be. He's always gonna be remembered by.
Yeah, you had a couple people where to follow you, Memo?
Guru Science.
Guru Science. Make sure to follow him. FaceReport.com. Melissa back reporting. So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.